The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said in the hadith, make good use of five matters before the occurrence of other five matters. Your life before your death, your youth age before you become old, your health before you become sick, your wealth before you become poor, and your free time before you become preoccupied. In this hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is urging us to utilize all these endowments from Allah Azza wa Jal in what benefits us in the hereafter, our life before our death. Because we all know that one day the angel of death will come to us and will take the soul out of the body. Now you are alive. Now you are walking on the ground. Tomorrow you'll be buried under the ground. So now you should work for the hereafter before it's too late. Also, you need to make good use of your youth age before you become old. Because what you can achieve and perform when you are young, you cannot do when you are old and tired. Also, utilize your wealth before you become poor. If you have money now, donate for the sake of Allah. Help the poor and the needy and the disadvantaged. Get rewards from the money that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided you with before you become poor. And that's when you start thinking about wishing that you have some money so you can donate for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also your health before your sickness. Now you can come to the mosque. There are some people, trust me, are crying because they are at home, unable to come to the mosque to attend a religious class, to pray in congregation. Now you find yourself able to come to the mosque. Utilize your health before it's too late. And the last one, your spare time, before you become preoccupied. Because if you do not fill your time with what benefits you, it will be filled with something that does not benefit you. How many people are wasting their time watching TV, watching games, and the like? So they spend hours and hours, especially in Ramadan, and they do not use that time in what benefits them in the hereafter. Abu Darda, one of the companions, radiallahu anhu, said, pray two rak'ahs in the darkness of the night for the darkness of the grave. Imam Ali radiallahu anhu said, people are oblivious, as if they are asleep. When they die, they wake up. They wake up, but it's too late. Now it's the time for one to work for the hereafter. Don't say, I'm busy, I have such and such. Make your religion your priority. And the rest of the matters, the worldly matters, you can do them tomorrow, after tomorrow. You can defer them, but the matters of your religion, don't defer them. Don't say, I'll do tomorrow, I'll do after tomorrow. I know one person, subhanAllah, who kept on deferring performing Hajj for years and years and years, until one day he decided to go to Hajj. He put his name down, he paid deposit, but suddenly he fell sick, and his sickness worsened to an extent that he died before being able to perform Hajj. Why you are saying next year and next year when you don't know if you are going to remain alive till the following year? Whatever you can achieve now of the good deeds, do them now before it's too late, before you become unable to come to the mosque. Another person who comes only for Friday prayer, he is unable to walk, he needs some help. He cries, and he asked me once, saying, make dua for me that at least I remain able to come to Friday prayer. Now look at yourself, you can walk, you can drive a car, you can come to the mosque. Nothing stops you from performing these acts of obedience. So why you are putting religion as not your first priority? Always make your religion your first priority and leave the other matters till another time, because even if you miss them out, nothing is going to happen to you. But if you miss out some of the obligations, that will be recorded against you. If you commit some of the sins, that will be recorded against you. And if you die without repentance, these will be shown to you on the day of judgment in your book. Repent to Allah Azza wa Jal. Utilize your life, your youth age, your health, your spare time, your richness before it's too late. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best.